You've probably never heard of Raine Island, and this might be your only chance to see it. It's tiny, right at the top of the Great Barrier Reef, but an absolute treasure. A place so wild, so precious, it's been declared off-limits to all but a few dedicated scientists. Just recently, I was lucky enough to join one of their expeditions, and what an amazing adventure that turned out to be. First, there were the turtles, thousands of them, right in the middle of their breeding season. Then, the sharks, huge tigers. Wait till you see what we had to do with them. Exhilarating stuff, all in the name of science. It looks like just a drop in the ocean. But Raine Island, way up off Cape York, is the jewel in the crown of the Great Barrier Reef, an ecological treasure. It's the single most important island for tropical seabirds in Australia. And it's here that thousands of the exquisite but endangered green sea turtle come to breed.
So in the world, is this one of the places for green sea turtles?
In the world, this is the place. This is the world's largest aggregation of breeding green turtles anywhere in the world.
And following the turtles are sharks, and lots of them, including massive tiger sharks. For the green sea turtle, life is an epic battle for survival.
All the trials and tribulations that these animals go through just to get off the island itself, and all the predators they face, and then to come back again, possibly 2,000 kilometres. You have to admire their tenacity, and you have to admire their will to survive.
You love these old girls, don't you?
You can't but not love them. I mean, they're beautiful. T67954.
Dr. Mark Reed is passionate about saving these creatures. And it's not just the predators he's worried about. There's overfishing, poaching, but the most pressing problem, this island is disappearing into the sea.
Is it a crisis?
For the green sea turtle, yes, it is a crisis.
So when this Queensland Parks and Wildlife biologist sees an exhausted green sea turtle on the beach, cooking in the sun, he's not one to let nature take its course.
Right up into the shoulder.
Yep.
And then we're going to start to drag.
So like that?
Yep, that's good. And you start to drag.
Oh. Jesus.
For all its grace in the water, the turtle is heavier than a wet sack of cement on land. All 130 kilos of it.
That's only about 8 metres.
Feels like 80. We're nearly there.
We're nearly there. All right, darling.
Run home.
We're on the downhill leg now. Two, three.
Yes,
all right, that'll do it. There you go, darling.
There she goes. Her lucky day, eh?
Yeah, it is her lucky day.
I feel good about that.
Yeah, I do too. Well done.
Good on you.
Green sea turtles have been coming here since well before the birth of Christ. Tonight, about 7,000 of these beautiful creatures who have travelled thousands of kilometres have returned to the very place where many of them were born. They'll struggle up the beach and lay their own eggs. And then, exhausted, they'll clamber down here, out into the ocean. This really is one of the great migrations on the planet, a true wonder of nature.
How many eggs will she deliver tonight?
Usually between 70 and 120, but average clutch is about 100 eggs. And the really interesting thing with sea turtles is the fact that it's not actually the contribution from mum and dad that determines the sex, it's actually the incubation temperature, with warm temperatures producing females and cooler temperatures producing males.
So the sex of those eggs that she's laying right now is yet to be determined?
Absolutely, yep.
In 6 to 8 weeks, they'll hatch, the sands of Raine Island literally bursting with life.
Like little rubber toys, aren't they?
They are like rubber toys. In many ways, they're also like a little wind-up toy because they've just got so much frantic energy. They're just waiting to go.
As cute as these little turtles are, their odds of surviving to adulthood are very slim. One in 1,000 will make it. Life for a green sea turtle is a real battle. Just watch how short it can be when a hatchling encounters a reef shark.
In the blink of an eye, that hatchling's gone.
In a blink of an eye, that hatchling is gone. Huh. Just a clear illustration of the challenges that a green sea turtle faces in its life.
The most impressive sight is when you're sitting on the water's edge here, and you see the turtles going in, and just 1 or 2 metres out in water, you know, chest deep, is a 4-metre tiger shark just slowly cruising up the line, looking for either a dead turtle or an easy prey item coming off the beach.
Do tiger sharks have table manners?
Not overly. When they hit pretty hard.
The tiger shark is known as the king of the tropics, and Raine Island is their favourite realm for hunting turtles. These two very different creatures share a violent but essential relationship here. And for marine biologist Richard Fitzpatrick, this atoll is the best place to catch, tag, and track tiger sharks.
The eye, when we tag them, you get in the water with them, and you're looking at that eye, you know, there's something there. And everyone thinks the sharks are being just mindless animals, but the tagging we're doing on these animals are showing movement patterns that are there for a reason. It's trying to get in there and work out what these reasons are. That's the real challenge at the moment.
Sorry, mate, I'm even nervous with a dead fish head. So what am I going to be like with a tiger?
It was a daunting prospect. Richard assures me that constructing this tuna head necklace was the best way to come face to face with a tiger shark.
The idea of using these heads is they're big and bony, so that when the tiger comes and bites it, it's not going to rip it all apart, because we want to be able to play the shark in so we can get it close enough to catch it.
It might sound radical, but it's not as wild as it used to be when Richard caught tigers with a barbless hook and a tail rope. But necessity was the mother of invention. For the sake of the shark and scientist, he invented the tail claw.
It's like a handcuff, essentially. And the idea is we'll pull the shark to the side of the boat, that'll be your job, and then when we get the shark there, this will be on a long pole, and basically just snap it over the base of the shark's tail, comes off the pole, got a rope and a big float, throw it all in the water, and the shark swims off dragging the big float, and what'll happen with them is within 60 seconds the tiger will stop swimming, and we'll go over, pick up the float, tie it back to the boat and tag it. So it's very easy.
Pick it out, ready? There we go. Here's Sharky Sharky.
We have to send it out a long way because they're very timid.
Tigers are timid?
Yeah. That could circle this for an hour or two. The funny thing about tigers, so timid. People just don't think of that.
You're just trying to make me feel better.
You're your own, mate.
They say shark research is hours of boredom followed by seconds of terror. 4 hours later, I knew exactly what they meant.
Oh, he's up bigger.
Okay, straight in towards us, mate. Bring it in. Come up, tail. Come up, and... Oh, shit, it's big. Oh. And...
He's taking your clamp.
That's how you catch a tiger shark. Look at that. We've got it.
We've got him. We've got him.
Whoa, she's under us.
Oh, shit.
Hang on, mate.
There she is.
I don't mind admitting it, I was very scared. This female tiger shark was by far the biggest shark I had ever seen.
I have a suspicion she's either the largest or second largest we've ever done this way.
She is big.
Tail roping sharks immobilises them, but it's not over yet. For stage two, Richard jumps into the water to slide a strap under her body so we could lift the shark alongside the boat.
Jeez.
Close.
Close?
Very close. It's gone down the ankle again.
Go out again. Yes, that's it.
I got her.
Okay.
3 meters,
0.52. 3.52?
Yeah.
I thought she was going to be 4. Anyhow, goes to show you always overestimate your fish.
The point of the exercise was this very small, very expensive piece of technology. A brand new satellite tag that, when fitted, will provide critical new information about tiger sharks.
In the past, our sat tags only gave us the position of the animal when it came to the surface. This tag not only will give us the position when the animal's on the surface, it's also going to upload information about what depths the shark has been doing.
Richard's research has already revealed that the tiger shark is not a mindless predator. Everything they do has a purpose, and Raine Island is one of the key habitats for these animals.
Looks good.
Looks fantastic.
This is a satellite tracking map of a tiger Richard tagged a year ago. It shows the shark, called Adam, continually returning to Raine Island, but also heading way out into the Coral Sea.
So it's one of the biggest revelations is that tiger sharks are an oceanic animal. They're spending a lot of time out there. And then Adam, about 5 weeks ago, with the turtle numbers coming back, lo and behold, he's here right now, swimming around. He's maybe avoiding me at the moment, but he's still here. And so we now have an out and back over 12 months, and that's scientific, it's phenomenal. We're so excited about that, to show that return pattern.
But as the tiger shark we christened Rainbow swam off, scientists are increasingly alarmed that Raine Island, this crucial haven for both sharks and turtles, is under grave threat. The island is being washed away.
We're dealing with a very serious situation already. You know, given that we should predict that we're getting 80% or more of the nest being successful at the moment, we think it's somewhere, you know, 10% or less.
These are eggs that have probably been tossed up by another turtle as it's been digging its nest, simply because there's so many turtles, as you can see, nesting on Raine Island. And the fact is that we're recording that the amount of sand that they have to nest in is slowly but surely decreasing.
The island is clearly disappearing.
In many respects, the island is disappearing.
It's vanishing because 100 years ago, Raine Island was mined for phosphate. To get it off the island, they blasted a hole in the reef to build a wharf for the ships. Scientists believe this channel is acting like a drain into which the sand is disappearing.
Oh, they're so heavy.
As nesting becomes harder and harder, more turtles are perishing in the scramble for beach space.
Ready? Go. Ready.
There you go, darling.
Good luck.
Gee, it's great that we can get them back out there.
It is.
It's really great. But there's a lot, isn't there? These cliffs, they just come tumbling over and just flip and...
They can't right themselves once they fall over.
Righting a turtle is easy enough. Fixing the island is a much tougher proposition. Last November, a team from Queensland Parks and Wildlife was dispatched to explore ways of doing just that. The stakes are huge. If the sand loss isn't reversed, the population of green sea turtles will be decimated.
Why should we care? Just think about it, Peter. In 30 years' time, we may not be able to sit here and have this conversation with turtles nesting all around us. So our children might not be able to see these animals in the wild. To me, that's quite a travesty. I want my kids to be able to appreciate sea turtles.
One, two, three. She's happy.
She's off.
She's gone.
Hello, I'm Sarah Abo. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9Now app for full episodes and other exclusive 60 Minutes content.